Few machines capture the essence of national military philosophy like main battle tanks. And in Europe, none do it better than the French Leclerc and the German Leopard 2. These two armored giants were shaped by the same Cold War threat, but took radically different paths to answer it. The Leclerc is a sleek, high-tech predator built around speed, automation, and advanced systems. A tank designed to strike first and move fast. The Leopard 2, by contrast, is a powerhouse of balanced engineering, combining firepower, armor, and dependability into a battlefield juggernaut. Both are devastatingly effective, yet their designs reflect two very different visions of what it takes to win in modern warfare. The Leclerc main battle tank stands as a testament to France's commitment to independent defense innovation. Developed by Giat Industries, now part of KNDS France, in the late 20th century, the Leclerc was introduced to replace the aging AMX-30 and to assert France's technological prowess in armored warfare. Named in honor of Marshal Philippe Leclerc de Hautecloque, a revered World War II commander, the tank embodies a blend of advanced engineering and strategic foresight. Entering service with the French Army in 1992, the Leclerc was among the first Western tanks to feature a fully automated loading system, reducing crew requirements and enhancing firing efficiency. If you believe the Abrams is the cornerstone of NATO's armored might, it's time to reconsider. The Leopard 2, a product of Cold War urgency, was developed to counter the Soviet Union's massive numerical edge in armor, outnumbering NATO nearly 3-1. It was purpose-built to dominate Soviet armor, and its innovations were so significant that even the M1 Abrams borrowed from its blueprint. With unmatched lethality and modern engineering, the Leopard 2 quickly established itself as a battlefield apex predator and remains a benchmark of armored warfare today. At the core of the Leopard 2's design was a deliberate pursuit of balance between protection, mobility, and firepower. Where other main battle tanks of the era often prioritized one capability at the cost of another, the Leopard 2 was engineered to harmonize all three. This commitment to versatility made it one of the most effective and adaptable armored platforms ever built. The Leclerc main battle tank exhibits a compact yet formidable design, tailored for modern armored warfare. With its 120mm smoothbore gun oriented forward, the tank measures approximately 32.4 feet in length, excluding the gun. The hull itself spans around 22.6 feet. The vehicle's width is around 11.8 feet, and it stands at a height of roughly 8.3 feet to the turret roof. These dimensions contribute to the Leclerc's agility and maneuverability on the battlefield, enabling it to navigate diverse terrains while maintaining a low profile to minimize exposure to enemy fire. The Leclerc main battle tank, developed by France's Nexter Systems, stands out as one of the lightest Western MBTs, with its combat weight varying across different versions. The initial Series 1 models weigh approximately 54.5 tons, while the Series 2 and Series 11 variants have increased weights of around 56.3 tons and 57.4 tons, respectively, due to added armor and upgraded systems. The latest Leclerc XLR, part of Spain's Scorpion modernization program, has a combat weight of about 57 tons. This increase accommodates enhancements such as modular armor, advanced electronics, and improved battlefield connectivity. In terms of size, both the Leopard 2A7 and the newer 2A8 maintain a commanding presence on the battlefield. They measure approximately 36 feet in length with the gun forward, around 13.1 feet in width, and stand about 9.8 feet tall to the top of the turret. These dimensions reflect not only the tank's considerable firepower and protection systems, but also its ability to accommodate advanced electronics and crew survivability features. The increase in size over earlier models is a direct result of additional armor modules, upgraded situational awareness systems, and integrated active protection systems in the 2A8, all of which are geared toward countering modern threats such as top attack munitions and anti-tank guided missiles. The Leopard 2A7 has a combat weight of approximately 68 tons, reflecting the integration of additional armor and advanced systems designed to enhance battlefield survivability. The Leopard 2A8, the latest variant, maintains a similar weight profile, ranging between 65 and 67 tons, depending on specific configurations and the inclusion of systems like the Trophy Active Protection System. The Leclerc's armor and protection systems reflect France's emphasis on survivability through advanced engineering rather than sheer mass. At the heart of the tank's defensive capabilities lies its modular composite armor, which can be readily replaced or upgraded in the field, a key feature that allows the Leclerc to adapt to evolving threats. The core structure integrates welded steel with ceramic and titanium inserts, offering a balanced protection-to-weight ratio against both kinetic energy penetrators and shaped charges. While specific armor thicknesses remain classified, the Leclerc's protection levels are considered on par with Western counterparts, like the Leopard 2 and M1A2 Abrams. Additionally, the tank incorporates a nuclear, biological, and chemical protection system, automatic fire suppression units, and a suite of electronic countermeasures. These include the Galax self-defense system, capable of deploying smoke grenades, infrared screening charges, and decoys to disrupt enemy targeting systems. In its latest XLR upgrade, the Leclerc benefits from enhanced protection modules, particularly against improvised explosive devices and anti-tank mines, reinforcing its role in asymmetric warfare environments. The Leopard 2 employs a multi-layered spaced armor design throughout its structure. This complex armor is constructed from steel plates of diverse hardness levels, combined with elastic substances and other non-metallic components. It's been speculated that the tank might use what's known as Burlington armor, a composite matrix reportedly developed by the United Kingdom and shared with West Germany. Additional layers of armor are bolted onto the face of the turret on Leopards of the A5 variant and later versions to protect the tank from a frontal assault. In this upgrade, the roof covering and armor modules is cut open, and new armor modules are inserted to offer better protection against modern AT systems like Javelin. The A7 Plus variant has a passive all-around protection for the crew from threats such as IEDs, mines, or anti-tank fire. For urban combat, the Leopard 2 can be outfitted with various modular armor packages. The design of the Leopard 2 adheres to the concept of compartmentation. Possible fire or explosion sources have been relocated away from the crew. The blow-off panels on the compartment roofs will direct the explosion and fire away from the crew in the event of a detonation. The Leopard 2 is equipped with a Dragger NBC overpressurization system to protect the crew from nuclear, biological, and chemical threats. What about their mobility? The Leclerc's engine and mobility are central to its reputation as one of the most agile main battle tanks in the world. Powered by the French-developed SACM V8X 1500 hyperbar diesel engine, the Leclerc produces 1500 horsepower and is paired with an automatic SESM ESM 500 transmission system, which includes 5 forward and 2 reverse gears. This powertrain enables the 60-ton tank to reach a top road speed of about 45 miles per hour and an acceleration from 0 to 20 miles per hour in just 6 seconds, figures that rival lighter armored vehicles. The Leclerc's hydropneumatic suspension system further enhances cross-country mobility, allowing the tank to adjust its ground clearance and adapt to rough, uneven terrain with exceptional stability and crew comfort. Its operational range stands at approximately 340 miles on internal fuel, extendable with auxiliary fuel drums. Thanks to its high power-to-weight ratio and advanced suspension, the Leclerc is uniquely suited for rapid maneuvers, combined arms operations, and high-tempo armored warfare, maintaining both speed and precision, even in complex environments. Powered by a water-cooled 12-cylinder MTU MB873 diesel engine with 1,500 horsepower, this cat is one of the fastest tanks around. More than 21 horsepower per ton is sufficient to propel the 73-ton armored giant to a maximum speed of 43 miles per hour. The Leclerc main battle tank operates with a crew of three: a commander, a gunner, and a driver. This streamlined configuration is made possible by the integration of an advanced autoloader system, which automates the loading of the 120mm main gun, eliminating the need for a dedicated loader. The driver is positioned at the front left of the hull, while the gunner and commander are seated in the turret, the gunner on the right and the commander on the left. This arrangement not only reduces the overall crew size, but also minimizes the tank's internal volume, contributing to a lower profile and potentially enhancing survivability on the battlefield. The autoloader system allows for a high rate of fire and enables the crew to focus on tactical operations without the physical demands of manual loading. Just like a hunting feline, this tank is very aware. The commander is equipped with an independently stabilized panoramic periscope sight for day and night observation and target identification. It provides a 360-degree view in every direction. The commander's periscope thermal image is displayed on a monitor inside the tank. The Leopard 2 A7 Plus has combined driver night vision for front and rear view, as well as improved optronics for reconnaissance over great distances. The weapon systems of these tanks are a direct manifestation of their nation's approach to armored lethality, each engineered not just to survive on the battlefield, but to dominate it. Whether through cutting-edge fire control, high-velocity main guns, or rapid autoloaders, these machines are built to deliver swift, decisive firepower capable of neutralizing threats before they can strike. The Leclerc is armed with a potent and highly integrated weapons suite centered around the Giat CN-120-26-52 smoothbore 120mm main gun. This NATO standard weapon, with a barrel length of 52 calibers, is longer than that of many Western NBTs, giving its rounds greater muzzle velocity and armor penetration capabilities. Uniquely, the Leclerc employs a bustle-mounted autoloader system, capable of firing up to 12 rounds per minute, allowing for a crew of just three and consistent high-rate engagement without crew fatigue. The gun can fire a full range of NATO-compatible ammunition, including APF-SDS and heat rounds, with a ready-use carousel of 22 shells. Complementing the main gun is a coaxial 12.7mm machine gun and a roof-mounted 7.62mm machine gun, typically operated by the commander for anti-infantry and anti-air defense. Target acquisition and fire control are managed by a digital fire control system integrated with a stabilized panoramic sight for the commander and a dual-axis stabilized sight for the gunner, both of which include thermal imaging and laser rangefinders. These systems give the Leclerc true hunter-killer capability, allowing it to track, engage, and destroy targets while on the move, day or night, under all battlefield conditions. The Rheinmetall 120mm smoothbore gun, which was later adapted for use on the M1 Abrams, is the primary armament for the production versions of the Leopard 2 in either the L-44 variant or the modern L-55 variant. It has one of the most advanced fire control systems in the world, which includes a ballistic computer, laser rangefinder, and thermal night vision, making it comparable to the American M1 Abrams. This enables the tank to engage targets with high first-round hit accuracy, day or night, and even through enemy smoke screens when engaging moving enemy targets. According to reports, the Rheinmetall DM-53 and DM-63 rounds are capable of penetrating 750mm of tank armor at a distance of 1.2 miles when fired from the L-55. Rheinmetall has also developed an upgrade for Leopard 2 tanks that enables them to fire the Israeli Lahat anti-tank guided missile, which can engage targets up to 20,000 feet away from the main gun. The tank is equipped with two machine guns, one mounted coaxially and the other on an anti-aircraft mount. The Leopard 2 A7 Plus also boasts a stabilized remote-controllable weapon station that can be equipped with a wide range of weapons, including the infamous Browning M2 HB 50 caliber. This concludes our episode that provides a glimpse into the mighty Leclerc and Leopard 2 main battle tanks. So what do you think about these remarkable tanks? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you were lucky enough to see these tanks up close, or better yet, operated one, please comment. Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.